हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज मिस्टर विपुल संसारे। वंस अगेन वेलकम यू इन अवर न्यू वीडियो लेक्चर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू द माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, दैट इज डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट्स। सो द वेरियस डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट आर यूज फॉर द डायग्नोसिस ऑफ वेरियस डिसीज कंडीशंस। सो दिस डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट आर ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एज पर द कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जामिनेशंस लाइक ए जीपैट। दैट क्वेश्चंस आर जनरली आस्क्ड based on the name of a diagnostic test used for the diagnosis of particular disease. So we are going to see a diagnostic test as a very important topic as per the competitive examination like a GPAT is concerned. So throughout this lecture we will see the various diagnostic tests along with the disease diagnosed by that particular test. So here you can see the two different diagnostic tests are used for the diagnosis of scarlet fever. So first is Dick test and second is Skolds-Carlatten test. So these are the two different tests used for the diagnosis of scarlet fever, that is the Dick test and Skolds-Carlatten test. Next, four different tests are used for the diagnosis of tuberculosis. The four different tests are there. First is tuberculin test, second is Mantoux test, third is Tyne test, and fourth is Hef test. So these are the four different tests, that is tuberculin test, Mantoux test, Tyne test, and Hef test. So you can remember like this thing, TMTH. The TMTH means T indicate the tuberculin test, M indicate the Mantoux test, T indicate the Tyne test, and H indicate the Hef test. That is TMTH is equal to tuberculosis. Next, one test used for the diagnosis of hemophilia, that is Ducre test. So this Ducre test is used for the diagnosis of hemophilia. Next, for a diagnosis of typhoid, one test is used, that is Vidal test. So Vidal test is used for the diagnosis of typhoid. Next, for diagnosis of diphtheria, again two different tests are used. First is Schick test and second is Lake test. The Schick test and Lake test used for the diagnosis of diphtheria. Next, for diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis, it is again autoimmune disease. Rheumatoid arthritis is diagnosed using a simple test, that is rose water test. Rose water test. So this rose water test, the capital R indicate the rheumatoid arthritis. So in this way you can remember, the R indicate the rheumatoid arthritis means again rose water test, right? Next, for diagnosis of lymphogranuloma venericum, for diagnosis of lymphogranuloma venereum, Frey test is used, that is Frey test. Next, for mononucleosis diagnosis, Powell-Bunnell test is used, Powell-Bunnell test. Next, the three different tests are used for the diagnosis of syphilis. First is VDRL test, next is Kahn test, and third is Wasserman test. So VKW is equal to syphilis, that is V indicate the VDRL test, K indicate the Kahn test, W indicate the Wasserman test. So VKW is equal to syphilis. In this way you can remember. Next, for diagnosis of typhus fever, Well-Flix test is used, Well-Flix test. Next, for diagnosis of pneumonia, cold hemagglutination test. Cold hemagglutination test is used for diagnosis of pneumonia. Again, lepromine test is used for diagnosis of leprosy. Again, lepromine test is used for diagnosis of leprosy, means capital L. L indicate the lepromine as well as the leprosy. So L indicate the lepromine and leprosy, means in this way you can remember. like what we have remember, the R indicates the rheumatoid arthritis, means rose water test is used for diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis. Similar way, L indicates the leprosy and lepromine test. Next, radial immunodiffusion. This radial immunodiffusion is used for diagnosis of influenza. This is a very important test for diagnosis of influenza. Radial immunodiffusion is used. Next, for diagnosis of typhus, typhoid and brucellosis, the tube agglutination test is used. The tube agglutination test for diagnosis of typhus, typhoid and brucellosis. Again, for diagnosis of AIDS, that is HIV AIDS, three different tests are used. First is Karpov's test, second is Fujikura test, and last is ELISA test, that is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, ELISA test. So KFE is equal to AIDS. KFE is equal to AIDS. In this way you can remember. Next, radio immunoassay or RIA. So this RIA is used to detect chronic gonadotropins in women serum, that is in pregnancy. So to detect the chronic gonadotropin in woman serum in pregnancy, this RIA is used, that is radio immunoassay. Next, last is COM test. So this COM test is used for brucellosis again. What we have studied, the tube agglutination test, that is for brucellosis, and COM test is also for brucellosis. Just see the question which has appeared in previous year GPAT examination. The Mantoux test is used. So this Mantoux test is used for diagnosis of tuberculosis. So this test used the old tuberculin, the correct answer. Whereas option number 2, 3, 4, these are the incorrect options. So only one correct option, that is option number 1, old tuberculin. Next, the Schick test is used to determine the susceptibility to, already we have studied, the Schick test is used for diagnosis of diphtheria. So the correct answer is option number 2, that is diphtheria. The tetanus, mumps and syphilis, these are the wrong answers. The correct answer is diphtheria, because Schick test is used for a diagnosis of diphtheria. So in this way the questions will ask in your competitive examinations like a GPAT. They will mention the name of a test or the name of a disease in question. Okay, so just thoroughly remember the different test as well as the different diseases diagnosis by that test. So this is again very important topic as per the competitive examinations like a GPAT. Thank you.